In a career spanning more than 50 years, Sir Cliff Richard has released more than 250 records, plus had more than 130 singles, albums and EPs make the UK top 20. And he's the only singer to have had a number one single in the UK in 5 consecutive decades. Studio 10's Bonnie Lythgoe caught up with her good friend Sir Cliff to talk about his brand new album. But first, let's remember some of his biggest hits. It's so funny.
Even begin to tell you how great it is to see you. I know I haven't seen you a long time ago, but it's always nice to catch up.
Well, it is, and you're always using my tennis courts. I mean, how can I ignore
I'm going to
you?
Tell them a funny story about the tennis court. One day he said, "You're doing really well. You remind me of Sue Barker." I went, "Great," thinking I'm a good player. But no, it was because I had the same kind of hat as her. Not funny, Cliff, but I just so want to talk to you about your new album. Just fabulous, yeah. Rock and roll. And I know how much you love rock and roll, and I just would love to know, how was it making this new album? Your 102nd, I think.
Yeah, it's the 102nd, and I've made one for every year of my life.
What? Hang on a minute. did you realise it took me a minute?
No, it was fun. Yeah, it was fantastic fun, you know. I've recorded the last few albums of mine in Nashville, Tennessee, and there's something about that place. It's as though everybody eats, lives, breathes music, and I get affected by it when I go there.
And tell me, which was your favourite song that you recorded on the album?
I had a dream that I would like to sing with Elvis, and then of course Elvis died so young. It was so heartbreaking for all of us who were his fans, but it meant that was not going to be possible anymore. And then of course the years go by and technology. Bonnie, you must have heard that record. Natalie Cole sang with her dad. Now, it was fantastic, and of course her dad died many years before she actually recorded with him. And so it became possible to do that. So I got in touch with Priscilla Presley first, and she said, because I wanted to do an album with him. And she said, well, I'm not sure, you know, whether they'd allow you to. If it was up to me, she said, I would say, yes, do the album. Because, and here's why I love it. She said, Elvis knew all about you. He said he kept his eye on his competitors. Elvis thought I was a competitor. I can't believe it. It was fantastic. So I got permission to do Blue Suede Shoes. And it was a little disturbing at first to sing with Elvis because I had the headset on and I'd sing, well, I'm one for the money, and then Elvis, too vulture. And I'm thinking, Elvis, Elvis. I had to go back and do a couple of my lines again because I was too busy listening to Elvis. Don't you step on my blue suede shoes. You can do anything but lay off for my blue suede shoes. My dream came true. Finally, I got to sing with the king.
It truly was quite magical. Have you ever thought about doing, say, take Roll Over Beethoven and put music to that, put a video to that, and actually do a whole video of one of the songs? And then I could go back in time, come on stage, and be one of your dancers like I used to be in the 70s.
I knew you had a motivation. You know me, I've done a lot of things on stage, and I have used dancers, and of course you were one of those dancers. Oh. And I'm so glad that's in my past.
That's it. I'm never talking to you again. I thought you were my friend. That's it. You know what, though, Cliff? When I was one of your dancers, it was so wonderful. We used to, all of us girls, just couldn't wait to be doing a number with you. Because Honestly, Cliff, you've got so much energy. And again, going back to your album, I sense that. I feel that. The energy and the love you have while you're doing your singing. It's just beautiful. It really is.
Well, thank you. You know, Bonnie, it's one of those things where if you don't actually like or love what you're doing in our business, regardless of whether you're a singer or an actor or a dancer, you aren't going to survive. Because in the end, some of the times are really tough. Yeah. You know, this must be about the 100th interview I've done in the last 5 days. And if you were sitting there thinking, oh, I don't want to do this, you'd go crazy. Yeah. But I actually enjoy presenting myself. I enjoy presenting albums. I like what I do. And that makes a big difference. And if you do love, someone said to me, if you find a job you love, you'll never work again in your life.
And so Cliff's fantastic new album, Fabulous Rock and Roll, is out now. And after the break, so Cliff opens up about the darkest hours in his life.